Hey everyone, this is Cyber Defenders, and we have MITRE 1594, an easy network forensics lab by Cyber Defenders. So let's read the scenario while the lab initiates. Adversaries may search websites owned by the victim for information that can be used during targeting. Victim-owned websites may contain a variety of details, including names of departments and divisions, physical locations, and data about key employees, such as names, rules, and contact information, for example, email addresses. These sites may also have details highlighting business operations and relationships. Adversaries also search victim-owned websites to gather actionable information. Information from these sources may reveal opportunities for other forms of reconnaissance, for example, phishing for information, researching open technical databases, establishing operational resources like establishing accounts or compromising accounts, and initial access. Now that the lab has booted up, let's see what we have. In the challenge folder, we have multiple log files. When we go into the tools directory, the only tool that we find is Zui. So let's open it and drop our log files for further analysis. Let's begin with reading the question number one. It says, loading Zeek logs in Brim Security. How many HTTP requests are there? To find the number of HTTP requests, we can go to any record and right-click on the path field, choosing the option Count by Field. This will display the counts of different values in the path field. It's just that simple. So let's submit that and proceed to the next question. Question two says, what is the domain of the targeted website? I typically start answering these types of questions by checking which websites are present in our logs. So I'll use the count function again, but this time I will count by the host field. This will reveal all the different hosts that have been contacted and the number of requests made to each. From there, we can see that the domain shop.cyberdefenders.corp has the most requests, which strongly indicates that it's the website being targeted. Question number three says, what is the tool used by the attacker to crawl the website? I begin by determining the IP address of the attacker. And since we already know that the attacker is trying to crawl the website, let's craft a query that will display how many requests each IP tries to make against the Cyber Defender's host. We can accomplish this by using the count function on the source IP field. And the IP with the most requests is likely the attacker's. So we'll use that IP for our next query. Our primary objective was to ascertain which tool was used to crawl this website. I started by inspecting the user agent of the HTTP request, but it appeared to be a standard browser, which offered little insight. My next approach was to examine the hosts the attacker tried to contact, but they only sent requests to the Cyber Defender's host. And after some thought, I decided to check the DNS requests and just filtered for the log type. And among the results, I spotted a DNS query to portswigger.net, which is the company behind Burp Suite, which is a popular software used for web application penetration testing that includes a built-in crawler. This should be the answer that we are looking for. Question number four says, how many web pages was the attacker able to access? We can determine this by querying the count function on the status code field. This will present all the status codes and their respective counts. And since 200 is the status code for a successful request, that gives us our answer. Question 5 says, what is the browser used by the attacker? Revisiting the user agent field in any of the HTTP requests sent by the attacker, we can see that the browser used is Firefox version 78. Question number 6. How many bytes did the attacker send? To obtain this information, we need a method to discern the number of bytes sent for each request. The best place for this information is the conlog type. This log type contains data at the TCP/IP level, covering TCP, UDP, and ICMP frames. In inspecting any of these conlog types, we observe a field for the sent bytes, enabling us to use the sum function on this field. And with this, we have addressed the final question in this lab. So, thanks for watching.